torturing me. Torturing me with a sweet, benevolent smile on her face. It makes no difference how sweet someone might be, although I really felt her more acidic. But if there are illegal border crossers in your world, and then into your mind, and they begin to whisper and walk through your life, serenely, calmly invading and torturing, it is a punishment, not a visit. And so, it's very difficult to be welcoming. I felt her like hard blows, like slaps against my sanity. She strolled through me as if I were phantom, and left pain and stings behind. No longer the unknown girl, she had become my unknown torturer, for reasons I could not even imagine, and the whispers always in my ears when I stopped moving. How did I handle this last week? Not well. I did it the way I always do. I ran, but not like a jogger, more like someone running for her life. I didn't speak to anyone. I didn't see anyone. Everyone was invisible, and all I saw was her when I closed my eyes, and the voices, more than her, distilled in me a panic as I knew this was a bad sign. And while I was having my closeted nervous breakdown, she was gliding through her world and dragging me behind her. The voices were like shards of brilliant glass, and his attacks were day and night. Oh, she hurt me, but just her presence was like a beating me down. And I would see her in my sleep, in the middle of trying to relax. She was always so smooth, so collected, walking with her serpents around her alien island, where night reigned and it seemed there was no mercy shown. My false bravery had turned into shrinking, begging fear. I feared her, for she was driving me mad. And I was defenseless, and she was angry. I had made her angry, I admit, because I had attacked her first. I would not be suffering her wrath today, perhaps, if I hadn't. Part of me waited to see if she might just kill me and just end this, but I always resurrected for more. Each new horrific hallucination made me think that death would be a much sweeter release. The attacks, the dreams, the waking nightmares, I don't think I can do this for much longer. I could not even meditate. I lost all concentration. And then, when I least expected it, I would see this image, a hallucination. Her snake would swallow me whole, and from inside of it, I would see it swallow itself as it spit me out, and she would be calmly walking. I ran everywhere, and she walked. She trampled my soul and muddied it with her smooth gliding walk. And I was so exhausted, I couldn't stop running, I couldn't stop thinking, I couldn't stop hearing the voices. I can't tell you, I was going mad, and I wondered why. Why is she doing this? Why did she come into my life? She never speaks to me. Not really, just a bunch of voices that I hear. Those voices. And I'm so tired. I will offer her to you. She will be my offering to you. to you.